This video is about EQ carving and ducking of audio under dialogue. And from the outset, let me say that good audio is about nailing it in camera. Believe me, fixing audio in post is not easy, but then again, it's not impossible. And be aware that the results will vary depending on the quality of the audio and the mix. In the video, we're not so much worried about fixing the audio, but improving the mix between the dialogue and the music track. And I'm going to show you how to improve this mix with EQ carving. I'm Bruce McBride, and I can provide personal training over the internet. Just click the link training.finalcutpro.com. It seems that video editors are not good audio engineers, maybe because they've not grown up with the discipline, or are using a different hemisphere of the brain, who knows? The reasons don't matter. It's what you do to correct the issue that's important. Audio is said to be 70% of the total value of a video, and this has something to do with the structure of the eyes as compared to the ears. Humans are prepared to watch bad images longer than they put up with bad audio. So you'll get longer viewing times if your audio is good than if your images are good and your audio is off or not good. We may not be expert at audio, but there's no harm in trying to be better. First up, some setup suggestions whenever you're working with audio. The following principles apply to any video editing program and most audio editing programs, but for this video, let's concentrate on Final Cut Pro. My first suggestion is to make sure that your audio meters are showing on the right-hand side of your screen. And to do this, just simply click on the audio meters in the middle menu bar, or you could use Shift Command 8. My second suggestion is to adjust the levels in the inspector. It's much easier to move. So if we select this clip here and go to the audio, you can then select your volumes. You can even type in a number there, but you can move them up and down in the timeline. And to see this much more clearly, you can increase the height of your timeline. So let's increase the amount of audio and increase the height of that audio. Just for the exercise, we'll show some more of the timeline compared to the viewer. Now you can see the adjustment line much more clearly. And a tip, if you want finer adjustment to that audio line, hold the command key while you're adjusting, and then you'll get much finer control. And my third suggestion is to keep the audio levels between minus 12 and minus 6. But if you're working with YouTube, well, then you could go up to minus 3. And now on to mixing the music with your dialogue. There's a very simple fix if you want to do it for background audio. Keep the volume between minus 30 and minus 40. And that's the quickest fix of them all. Now you can walk away. You won't get the best results, but you will be able to hear your voice without the music getting in the way.
To understand the mechanics and the workflow in order to smooth.
But let's look at the best way to mix dialogue and music with EQ carving to reduce some frequencies in the music and increase clarity in the dialogue. And it's a little bit like color correction in that small changes are significant, but it's dangerous to make too much of a change. And as I say, a little bit is too much. Here's a dialogue track and a music track. If we play through that now, we'll find that the music is too dominant.
To understand the mechanics and the workflow, in order to smooth the editing process and create films.
And since this dialogue is made up of a number of different clips, I'm going to select them all and we'll make them into a compound clip. Right click and compound clip.
Now we're going to select a channel EQ and add that to both the dialogue and to the music track.
Now let's select the dialogue, and looking over in the inspector here, we can see this little icon which will open up the channel EQ. We'll do the same for the music track, select that in the timeline and click on the little icon here, and then that opens up the channel EQ for the music track as well.
If we select the analyzer for both of these and then play through, we'll see the audio waveforms for both the dialogue and for the music. These work with the lowest levels being the lowest frequency and the highest levels being the highest frequency.
A male voice is usually between 80 and 250 hertz, and a female usually between 160 and 250, and kids 250 to 300.
You can see my voice frequency is higher than a normal male's frequency. So mine's between 100 and 500, and a normal male is between 80 and 250. It shows that you need to check the frequency for each voice you're working with. As you can see, that can vary dramatically.
The other frequencies give color to my voice. I'm going to turn on the rolls and we'll listen to the same track, but without the music turned on.
While this is not as feature rich as Final Cut Pro. While this is not as feature rich as Final Cut Pro.
And you'll see how the vibrancy of the total clip is severely reduced without the music. What we need to do from here, let's turn the music back on again in the rolls, and we're going to boost up the dialogue audio. So to carve out this audio, I'm going to increase the dominant frequencies in the voice. So we'll take that up and we'll move it between the areas that are dominant.
To express themselves.
So let's just move that a little bit more down here. And we'll do the same thing in the music, but we're going to decrease the amount of that frequency in the music.
Those using Final Cut as their tool of choice to understand the mechanics and the...
So let's move this one up a little bit more. And we can widen or narrow the amount of frequency that we're responding to. Widen that one a little bit there. So we're going roughly between the 100 and the 500. That roughly covers the area of the voice there. And we'll do the same in this one. So we'll take that through so it's covering through. We could cut off these ends here. They're not needed. And you could do it with the highs as well. This adjusting of the range is called the Q, and you can access that by selecting these lines as we've seen, or you can use Command Option while you're dragging up. So if you hold the Command Option key down, you'll see a little Q appears. And if you want to enhance the music in the areas where the dialogue is not existing,
to express themselves to the world,
let's just zoom into that particular location. And with the R key, you can simply select that area where that music wants to go up, then slide up the volume levels. And when you move away from that now, you can see Final Cut has put in keyframes that you can modify as you want to. So play through that.
Press themselves to the world. Don't disregard iMovie.
And from here, you can adjust the volume of your dialogue or your music. In this case, we're going into YouTube, so we want it up somewhere around the -3.
In order to smooth the editing process,
we could marginally take it up a couple of decibels.
To smooth the editing process and create films to express themselves to the world.
I hope you've enjoyed this video. Thank you for watching. Please like, subscribe, and press the bell. There are new videos every Sunday.